Let's talk about how bonds are issued and traded, and focus specifically on US government bonds. The Department of the Treasury, a part of the US government, conducts regular auctions to sell T-bill notes and bonds. The act of selling a security for the first time is referred to as issuing a security, and the entity that issues the security is called the issuer. The market in which investors buy newly issued securities is called the primary market. Investors buy these newly minted bonds from the Treasury at a price determined in the auction. So money is transferred from the investors to the government, and these investors receive the bonds. Over time, and if investors decide to keep the bond, the Treasury makes coupon and principal payments to them. However, the investors who buy the bonds in the primary market do not have to keep them until maturity. Indeed, there is a very active market for T-bill notes and bonds. This market is referred to as the secondary market. In these markets, investors trade with each other and the issuer is not involved. Let's say that you purchase a note in the primary market that promises 10 semi-annual coupons plus the principal at maturity. Let's say that you collect the first 8 coupons, and at that point you decide to sell the note to a different investor. You transfer ownership of the note to this new investor at a price. The new investor will then only receive the remaining 2 coupons and principal payment, unless, of course, she decides to sell before maturity. When we talk about the price of a bond, we refer either to the price at which the bond is issued or its price in this secondary market. As you can imagine, the price of the bond will depend, among other things, on when you buy it. In the example we just discussed, the price you pay for the bond at issuance should factor the fact that you will receive 10 coupons and the principal, whereas the price at which you sold the bond to this new investor should factor the fact that there are only 2 coupons and principal left.